Hey everybody, I just thought I'd let you guys know, for those of you who haven't heard or seen the threads or anything, just thought I'd let you guys know my Savannah monitor, Lrrr, he died on Wednesday, September 7th, and I'll just go through what happened. I was laying in bed, sleeping, and I woke up at 5 a.m. to him making a lot of noise and just, I don't know, it sounded like there was a lot of commotion coming from his cage. So I went in there and I took him out just to see what was going on, because I had a feeling something was not right. I took him out and he was gasping for air, and he was struggling, like moving all weirdly, and he would put one arm forward and then the other leg would go forward. It was really robotic like, and I could tell I knew he wasn't gonna live through the night, so I wrapped him up in his little SpongeBob blanket, and I put him on me, and he put his little arms around my chest like that, with a little bear hug, like he always does, and then he was still gasping for air, but he wasn't struggling, he wasn't trying to move. As soon as he got on me and he was in my comfort, he completely chilled out. He stopped panicking, he stopped freaking out. So I had him laying with me for 10 or 20 minutes, and I was just watching him. His head was right here, so right by my face. And he closed his eyes, but he was still gasping for air. And then he just stopped struggling, and then I went to sleep. And when I woke up for school at 7:30, he was dead. Still on my chest, with his arms wrapped around me, in his blanket. And he just passed away when he was sleeping with me, I guess. So yeah, that's what happened. I'm very upset about it, but I'll get over it. I'll get to the point where I think about the good times instead of just, you know, his death and all the sadness that brings. So I'm hoping soon I'll feel a lot better about it and things will continue back to normal. But for those of you who haven't seen it, check out redtailboa.net and snakes.com, Snakes Forum, SSNAKESS. I posted a thread there, and I posted a thread on redtailboa.net about this. So if you guys want to see any more of that, just go there and check it out. Anyway, here's some video of him, just to remember him by. And I figure if he has to go out, he's going to go out with style, so I'm going to put some good music on it. So here he is.
This is the master thesis underneath the deepness. Come to myclub.net where you can read this. Run a plot on the map in hyperspace, yeah. From the Society for Scientific Exploration. Color is vibration, vibration is sound. Sound resonates through the mouth. Check it out, what I say vibrates no less than 9 ways. South, southeast, west, southwest, east, north, northeast, northwest. And the black and white images fade to gray sound waves. Trap my adversaries like a mouse in a maze with a bewildering array of lyrical display. The best abyss, orbitally rearranged, mortal atomic elements with adept intelligence. The highest professorship, my English etiquette compels me to not say it if I can't spell it, bitch. My circularized third eye sees all. Atlantis was surrounded by four sea walls. I read 1/4 of the Library of Alexandria before it was burnt to the floor. I wish I could have learned more about the shapes of the sacred geometry they used to draw. They were new millennium, but Euclidean in form. Ancient in many ways, but not nearly as old. Carved from Egyptian gold, molded in Assyria, with processed beryllium by the quintillion. They cooked on symmetrical stoves with my logo etched above the hole where they inserted the coal. And they barbecued burns to the bone, and they burned incense in the Buckminster Fuller type dome. I talked to Mr. Fuller over the phone, and he said he had a contract to rebuild Rome. He said he didn't want to do it alone. I told him I was busy writing poems, but I think about going. The process was slow and the dough was low, but I took it as the perfect opportunity to grow. Plus I had never traveled that far from home, but I heard about the beauty of Cydonian snow. Neon green grass, Statues made from translucent glass. I'd be crazy to pass. I like Algerian jazz. The Blue Twilight Band that plays tunes from a laser black sax. It sounds so laid back, it helps me relax. I bought the album after seeing K-Pax. Oh, how I miss my Nautilus. I was told Pharyngo Amygdalus did not exist. You have a minus case of scaphocephalus. I prescribed some neo-gothic antibiotics. Words concocted from the lyrical locksmith. Deadliest 10 droplets of rice and toxin. From every angle, the competition gets boxed in. As Dr. Z indoctrinates his doctrine. Translate the English alphabet to the Omega text. Life is now, but death is next. Postborn out of bell from the belly of hell. Communicate through diatonic and pentatonic scale. These dark side tales might affect sales. I set sail to hunt down and wreck sperm whales. Use the aphrodisiac to get a female. Call Ginger, tie her up and drink her ginger ale. Grand Marnier for me, scotch on the rocks for you. Your vocab is smaller than a cockatoo's. In the studio with James Lipton, reminiscing about the script that was written before the beginning. All of a sudden the booze turned to applause. My jaws stronger than the Kaninde macaws. Can't even count the balls I've expended so far. Don't wanna rap no more, it's been so long. I wish the clock would hurry up and tick. I'm out in the bush in the sticks, humping 100 clicks. Dr. Scholes gave me a good fit. Me and him went to school together back in 86. When I was really ill, putting flank energy in a rhyme the size of a Tylenol pill. You wanna laugh now and cast your belligerent doubt? Show you what poetry's really about. The side effects will make you pass out. Followed by skin rash, itching diarrhea, nausea, and dry mouth. You want a timeout? You better spit a rhyme out before the community of real MCs die out. College students say to me, you ain't smart. Record label A&R say, this ain't art. These are the contents of the covenant of the ark. Listen to my chest beat, tell me this ain't hard. You gotta be as obsequious as the disciples of Jesus. This is my master thesis.
Brenda's barely got a brain. A damn shame, the girl can hardly spell her name.
That's not our problem, that's up to Brenda's family.
Well, let me show you how it affects our whole community. Now Brenda really never knew her moms, and her dad was a junkie putting death into his arms. It's sad, cause I bet Brenda doesn't even know. Just cause you're in the ghetto doesn't mean you can't grow. But oh, that's a vote, my own revelation. Do whatever it takes to resist the temptation. Brenda got herself a boyfriend. Her boyfriend was a cousin, now let's rock the joy. And she tried to hide her pregnancy from a family who really didn't care to see or give a damn if she went out and had a church of kids. As long as when the check came, they got first dibs. Now Brenda's belly's getting bigger, but no one seems to notice any change in her figure. She's 12 years older, she's having a baby. In love with the molester who's sexing her crazy. And yet, and also thinks that'll be with her forever. And dreams of a world with the two of them are together. Whatever, he left there and she had the baby solo. She had it on the bathroom floor and didn't know, so she didn't know what to throw away and what to keep. She wrapped the baby up and threw him in a trash heap. I guess she thought she'd get away, wouldn't hear the cries. She didn't realize how much the little baby had her eyes. Now the baby's in a trash heap, bawling. Mama can't help her, but it hurts to hear her calling. Brenda wants to run away. Mama say you're making me lose pay. And social work is here every day. Now Brenda's gotta make her own way. Can't go to a family, they won't let her stay. No money, no babysitter, she couldn't keep a job. She tried to sell crack, but end up getting robbed. So now what's next? It ain't nothing left to sell. So she sees sex as a way of leaving hell. It's paying the rent, so she really can't complain. Prostitute found, swing. And Brenda's her name, she's gotta beg.